Hello students, welcome back to my YouTube channel PT Tutorial. And today in this video I am going to discuss problems based on Gauss divergence theorem. So I have already uploaded the video on Gauss divergence theorem. You may see the description box for the link. And let's start the problem. The first question is, evaluate surface integral x square dy dz plus y square dz dx plus 2z xy minus x minus y dx dy, where s is the surface of the cube which is bounded by this line. Okay, so I have drawn the picture. This is the cube and this is the respective coordinate. Okay, so from the university exam point of view, I am going to write the theory part also, so you can able to understand how to write it in the exam. So given integral is what? Surface integral x square dx dy dz plus y square dz dx plus 2z xy minus x minus y dx dy, which is in the form. So this is already discussed in the video of Gauss divergence theorem. The surface integral f1 dy dz, f2 dz dx, f3 dx dy. So we find that the value of f1 is x square, f2 is y square, and f3 is this part. So where f1 is x square, f2 is y square, and f3 is 2z xy minus x minus y. Now the vector point function, is given by f1 I cap, f2 j cap. I have already discussed all this line in the video. You may check this. X square I cap, the value of f1 is x square I cap, f2 y square j cap, and f3 is 2z xy minus x minus y k cap. Okay, so from Gauss divergence theorem, this integral vector point function f and ds is equals to volume integral delta dot f dv. Okay, you may also say surface integral f1 I cap, f2 j cap, f3 k cap and ds is equals to volume integral del f1 del x plus del f2 del y plus del f3 del z dv. Double integral s, f1 is x square dy dz, y square dz dx, 2z xy minus x minus y dx dy is equals to volume integral del f1, f1 is x square del x, del f2 that is y square del y, del upon del z, f3 is 2z xy minus x minus y. Solve it. This is 2x, this is 2y, y minus x minus y with respect to z. After solving, we get, if you have to write the limit for x dv, here we are going to put the value or limit of x. X runs from, it is already mentioned in the question, it runs from 0 to 1, y runs from 0 to 1, and similarly z runs from 0 to 1. So value x is equal to 0 to 1, for y is equal to 0 to 1, and z is equal to 0 to 1. After solving, we get 2x minus x, x, 2y minus y, y, and this is xy, dx, dy, dz. So after integrating this, 2 is left here also, so there is 2, 2xy minus 2x minus 2y. So cancel, this portion is cancelled, the only left part is 2xy. Okay, fine. Write it here, x is equals to 0 to 1, y is equals to 0 to 1, z is equals to 0 to 1, xy, dx, dy, dz. Start solving. 2x is equals to 0 to 1, y is equals to 0 to 1, z is equals to 0 to 1, dz, write xy outside, dx, dy, 0 to 1, y is equals to 0 to 1, this is x, dx, this is y. The value of z, the value of this integration is z, after putting the value, this will become 1, so this will simply become dy. Again, after solving for y, x dx, this will become y square upon 2. After solving, we get 1 upon 2. This will cancel here. Again, solving for this, we get x square upon 2. After solving, we get 1 upon 2. That is the answer. By transforming to a triple integral, evaluate this surface integral where S is closed surface bounded by the plane z is equals to 0 to z is equals to b and the cylinder x square plus y square is equals to a square. This is the equation of circle. So if we divide the part of cylinder, we found that it is the joint collection of circle that will make that cylinder. So this is the equation of that circle part. Let's start from here, from Gauss divergence theorem. We know that surface integral f dot n ds is equals to volume integral f delta f dv. Okay, so surface integral is given here, x cube dy dz, x square y dz dx, and x square z dx dy is equals to volume integral del x cube, that is f1. This is f1, this is f2, this is f3. So we have to find del f1 upon del x, del f2, that is x square y upon del y, and del f3, that is x square z upon del z dv. Okay, we have to put the limit here first. So z is runs from 0 to b, putting x is equals to 0, y is equals to plus minus a, and we have to find z is equals to 0 to b, y is equals to minus a to a, and x is equals to, in terms of y, we find the value of x. So x is equals to under root a square minus y square. This is a square minus y square minus x is equals to plus a square minus y square. After doing the partial derivation, we get 3x square. This will become x square. This will become x square again. This is dx, dy, dz. So we get the x coordinate only. So write it as, this is 3, 1, 4, this is 5. So keep the constant outside. Z is equals to 0 to b, y is equals to minus a to a, and x is equals to under root a square minus y square, sorry, minus plus a square minus y square. This is x square dx dy dz. After solving this, we are going to change some integral here. So this is the one of the property of integration. If it is equals to x is equal to minus a to plus a, it will become 0 to a twice of that integral, twice of integral 0 to a. Similarly, from y is equal to minus a to a, this is twice of 0 to a. Okay, so 2 and 2, that is 4. 4 comes out and it will become 0 to a. This will become 0 to under square under root a square minus 5 square. We write 4 multiply, 5 is already here, z is equal to 0 to b, there is y is equal to 0 to a, and this is x is equal to 0 to under root a square minus y square. Integration is x cube upon q. So there is no need to write the integration here. Directly put the limit a square minus y square dy dz. That is 20 upon, keep the constant outside, this is 3. This is z is equal to 0 to z is equal to b. This is y is equal to 0 to a. After putting the limit, upper limit, you get y a square minus y square to the power 3 by 2 dy dz. Now we are going to solve for dz. Write it here, z is equal to a. If we solve the integration for dz, you get simply z here, this is y. Okay. And the limit is z is equal to 0 to b. This will become 20 upon 3. Y is equal to 0 to a, b, a square minus y square 3 upon 2 dy. Put y is equal to a sine theta, a sine t dy, a cos t dt. Write it here. Get 3. Keep the b outside. This will become 0 to pi by 2, the value of t. And a square is a square, y is a square sine square t 3 upon 2 a cos t dt, the value of dy 20 upon 3 b. Take the a square common, you get a cube t is equal to 0 to pi by 2 a cube, and there is also a, that is a 4. This will become 1 minus sine square t. What is the value? Cos square t. Cos square t 3 upon 2. There is also cos t dt. The value of this is cos 4 dt. So I will write here 20 upon 3. This is a 4 b. If you know the integral of cos to the power n t dt directly, this will be written as 3 upon 4, 1 upon 2 dot pi by 2, from 0 to pi by 2. This is the direct integration, that is the formula. We get, this is already, I have already made the video on this also. You may check the description box. Pi by 2, after solving, cancel it. This will become 4, 5. This will become 5. Cancel, this will become 4 a 4 b pi. So this is the homework for you. You have to apply the divergence theorem to evaluate this surface integral which is bounded by sphere, and answer will be 69 upon 3 into pi. So I will give you one hint. This is clearly known that this is f1, this is f2, this is f3. So you have to find the partial derivative respectively. Del f upon del x, del f2 upon del y, del f3 upon del z. You will find the value easily. That will become any number. And this is dv. That volume integral dv is written there. You have to write the volume of sphere. What is the volume of sphere? 4 upon 3 pi r cube. R is what? 2. R is 2. That is 2 ka square. So this, the r is 2. You have to put the value of r there and you will find the answer. So next question we are going to discuss is, if S is an enclosed surface enclosing a volume V and F vector is equal to this, prove that surface integral F dot n ds is equal to CV. Okay, V is what? The volume. So let's start with the solution. So if you see, the F vector is given. So by Gauss divergence theorem, we have surface integral as f dot n ds is equals to what? Volume integral divergence f dot dv. Okay, for the divergence theorem we know that it is equals to divergence f is what? Del upon del x f1 is x, del upon del y, f2 is 2y, and del upon del z, f3 is 3z dv. Solve it. We get 1, 2 and 3 dv. Add it, we get 6. Try the constant outside. This is dv. After integration, we get is equal to 6v. So this is the answer. Option 1 question, which is for you, for your practice. This is the homework. Verify divergence theorem for f vector this. Taking over the rectangular parallel pipe from x, vary from 0 to a, 0 to b for y, and z vary from 0 to c. And I have also written the answer here. If you got the answer, please comment down below. And if you have any query, please comment down below also. I will make the video and show you how to solve the question. Okay. So move on to the next question. Evaluate the surface integral where S is the part of the sphere. And this is the equation of a sphere above the xy plane and bounded by their plane. Okay. So let's see how to solve it. So by divergence theorem, surface integral y square z square I cap, z square x square j cap, and z square y square k cap dot and ds is equals to volume integral divergence of y square z square I cap z square x square j cap plus j square y square k cap dv. Okay, this is F, where V is the volume of the sphere. Now solve this volume integral. This is del x. F1 is y square zx. Del del y, this is z square x square. Del del z is z square y square dv. So after solving, this will become 0, this will become 0, this will become 2z y square. This is triple integral dv. This can also be written as z y square dv. So we shall use a spherical polar coordinate r theta phi to evaluate this triple integral. The z coordinate is r cos theta. This is the polar coordinate for a sphere. It is already studied. Y is equals to r sin theta sin phi. Similarly, you can also know the polar coordinate for cylinder, and you can easily solve the integral. And we require dv. So dv is equals to what? R square sin theta dr d theta d phi. Okay. And r varies from 0 to 1. Similarly, theta varies from 0 to pi by 2, and phi varies from 0 to 2 pi. Get 2. Z is what? R cos theta. Y square is R square sin square theta sin square phi. And dr is, and dv is R square sin theta dr d theta d phi. To write it properly, writing to outside, this is constant. R is equal to from 0 to 1, theta is equal to 0 to pi by 2, and phi is from 0 to 2 pi. This will become R phi, sin cube theta, cos theta, sin square phi, dr, d theta, d phi. Start integrating with R to the power 5. This will be theta is equal to 0 to pi by 2, and this is phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi. After integrating r5, we get r6 upon 6 Okay, we get r6 upon 6. After putting the value 0 to 1, we get 1 upon 6. Put the constant outside, write the rest part. I'm integrating by skipping some step because it is very easy. So we will write 1 by 3. We are going to integrate this first. So write pi is equal to 0 to 2 pi sine square pi here. Put the bracket. Theta is equal to 0 to pi by 2 sine cube theta cos theta. This is d theta. This is d phi. So put the value sine theta is equal to t. It will become cos theta d theta is equal to dt. Write it here. Square pi. Now the value of t is putting theta 0, it will become 0, t is equal to 0, and putting pi by 2, it will become t is equal to 1. This is t cube, this is dt, d5. After solving, we get t4 upon 4. After putting the value, we get 1 by 4. Write the limit outside, this is constant, and write the rest part, this is sine square pi d5. Okay. This is 1 by 3, this is 1 by 4. Again, we are going to use one of the property of integration, that 0 to 2a fx dx is equals to 2 of 0 to a fx dx. So this will be written as 2 times of a by 2, okay. This will become a by 2, so this will become pi is equal to 0 to pi by 2 sine square pi d phi, sorry d phi. Cancel it out, this is 1 by 6. What is the sine square pi? This is again the formula of sine to the power m theta d theta. From 0 to pi, this will become 1 by 2 dot pi by 2. After solving, we get pi by 12. This is the answer. A few examples I have discussed based on cost divergence theorem. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, hit the like button, subscribe my channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon for further notification. And if you feel any query in any of the question or in homework part, please comment down below. And thanks for watching this video.